Hello, this is Harry Norman for Proactive Investors, and welcome to another Proactive Audio interview. Today is the 4th of July 2012, and I'm talking on the phone in Kelowna, BC, with Ross McElroy, President and COO of Fission Energy, listed on the TSX Venture Exchange General Mining Sector. Stock ticker FIS, share price 44 cents Canadian, market capitalization $50.52 million Canadian. Web address fission-energy.com. Ross, thank you very much for joining us for this interview.
My pleasure.
Ross, why did Rio Tinto Group outbid Cameco Corporation and pay $654 million to acquire the Athabasca Basin-focused uranium explorer Hathor Exploration?
Well, I think Rio Tinto made a corporate decision to become a major player in the uranium sector. So, you know, with that in mind, if you're going to be a major player in the sector, you want to have a significant toehold in the Athabasca Basin. And they looked at the Rough Rider deposits and realized that they were very high grade, that you were near infrastructure, you're in the prolific part of the eastern part of the basin where all of Canada's production comes from, strong infrastructure in place, a couple of mills nearby and highways, as well as the political support. So these are the things that attracted Rio to get involved in the basin, and these are the same reasons that I think investors would look towards Fission, because we're a significant player in the basin, and with our Waterbury Lake project right adjacent to the now Rio Tinto Rough Rider deposits, this is why Rio got into the basin.
Please would you give investors a brief introduction to Fission Energy and what makes Fission Energy stand out from the crowd?
Well, Fission Energy, I think what makes us stand out from the crowd is our exceptional land package in the Athabasca Basin. We were one of the first juniors out of the gates to acquire ground in the basin, so we were able to pick up very strategic pieces of ground near other major deposits in the area and also near infrastructure and mills. So that, and also the addition of a very strong management team with a track record of being able to run public companies well, raise money, keep the activity going, and a technical team that's second to none, which has led to our two major discoveries in the last 3 years. And I think that those are the aspects that sets us apart from other peers in our sector.
Please, would you talk us through the state of resources and exploration at Fission's Athabasca Basin Waterbury Lake prospects, especially the J-Zone project, which I believe grew in three directions last winter?
Well, the Waterbury Lake project is our flagship property where we have a 60% interest and a joint venture with the Korean consortium led by TEPCO. This is right adjacent to the Hathor Rough Rider deposits, which Rio Tinto recently bought. And there's also a number of other high-grade significant deposits in the area. The Riva Denison Midwest deposit is nearby. So you're really in an area that has a lot of high-grade deposits, six known high-grade deposits within a three-kilometer area. And the J-Zone is the latest and newest of these discoveries, and it continues to grow. We made our discovery in 2010. We've outlined a strike length on the J-Zone of over 670 meters, and our drilling this past winter has continued to grow, particularly the western half of the deposit with the mineralization, and as you mentioned, growing in three dimensions, vertically as well as along strike and laterally. So we're very optimistic with the J-Zone and where it's going.
What are your thoughts on Fission's new Athabasca Basin discovery, Patterson Lake South, where you found a high-grade boulder field?
Well, we think that this boulder field is very significant because, first of all, the grades of these boulders average almost 10% U308, so that's significant by any standards. The boulder field itself has been outlined over a dimension of 5 kilometers by 1 kilometer and sitting right at surface. So we believe these are transported boulders that come from a source location about 1 to 2 kilometers northwest of its current location. And so our drilling this last winter has been focused on testing for that source location. We believe that there's an in-situ deposit sitting somewhere in the middle of our property, and that's where we're focusing our attention. But we think that we have a very near-surface discovery of extremely high-grade uranium, and Patterson South has got the potential to be a major discovery.
Please tell us about your recent acquisition, Pitchstone Exploration, and what was compelling about this acquisition, Ross?
Well, the Pitchstone acquisition, I think, is pretty important because Pitchstone was one of the first juniors out of the gates in 2003, 2004 to stake a significant position in the Athabasca Basin. So with the acquisition of Pitchstone, we obtained another 13 projects in the basin. And I think significantly, we also gain new joint venture relationships. Pitchstone have a property in Namibia where Rio Tinto is a joint venture partner that is earning up to 49% of the property. So Rio Tinto would be a significant player for us because of the proximity of our Waterbury Lake project as well in the Athabasca Basin. So we think there's some synergies in there with having Rio as a joint venture partner that may come into play on the Waterbury Lake project as well in the Athabasca Basin.
What are your thoughts on Fission's Macusani project in southern Peru?
Well, Macusani district is a new and emerging uranium district. Fission's had its land position in the Macusani area since the late 90s. We haven't done a whole lot of work down there since then, but other people have been active. Cameco's had a joint venture with Vina Resources. Macusani Yellowcake and Southern Andes Uranium have recently been making good discoveries and putting together resources in the area. Our ground is key in that whole uranium district. We have surface showings of uranium. We just haven't spent a lot of time as we've been focusing on the Athabasca Basin, but we really believe in the potential of the Macusani area. And to that end, 2012, our intent is to become active down in that area. We want to get our projects to the drill-ready state and start drilling and hopefully putting together resources of our own. And corporately, we're considering a spin-off of the Macusani asset where Fission can remain focused on the Athabasca Basin and then Fission Energy in Peru can focus on the Macusani project.
On May 15th, Fission Energy held $17.5 million Canadian in cash. Please, will you talk us through the company's capital structure and financial situation going forward?
Sure. Well, as you say, we've got a little over $17 million in the treasury, and our institution owners, we believe, hold about 25% of the shares. Sprott Asset Management is the single largest shareholder with around 8% of Fission. But with the acquisition of the Pitchstone deal, we have around 125 million shares outstanding, and that will probably add about another $1 million to the treasury once the deal completes. So post-deal, we're approximately 125 million shares outstanding, $17, $18 million in the bank, and we're covered by several analysts, Dundee Securities, David Talbot, Versant, with Rob Chang. And out of London, we have VSA Capital. Paul Rankin covers us. So we're very well covered, we're very well financed, and good capital structure.
What exploration milestones and other events can investors expect from Fission over the next year to year and a half, Ross?
Well, we're going to continue to be aggressive on our top-tier properties. We'll focus on the Waterbury Lake project primarily, growing the J-Zone. I expect to have an updated 43-101 resource towards the end of 2012. We'll also continue to explore and work on the Patterson Lake South property, where we had encouraging results from this last winter, and that's where the high-grade boulder field sits. So you'll see news flow out of us on several of our top-tier properties in the basin, and with the new acquisition of Pitchstone, there's a number of properties as well that we'll be actively exploring and seeking joint venture partners on.
Remember, Proactive Investors is not an investment advice service. Make sure you register at proactiveinvestors.com or proactiveinvestors.co.uk for our weekly newsletter, which will keep you informed about our events, interviews, and articles. Thank you for listening.